official YouTube channel of our Bijaipur A-Levels, where we Bijayans would be uploading new YouTube videos, which will include all our academic as well as curricular activities, which will include creative, innovative as well as interesting topics. So this is our first YouTube video, and it's all about a vlog, which where we are going to three of the well-known places of Dharan Valley. So they are Panchakanya temple, Vrindavasini and Bijaipur Darbar. So let me first tell you guys about Dharan Valley. It's a really beautiful valley which is located at the foot of Mahabharat Hills. You can see there. It's a really beautiful valley with full of natural beauty and religiously sacred places and as well as historical places. This is also known as Eden of Stone Nepal because there are several educational institutions. So in overall, we can say that Dharan is a beautiful as well as prosperous place. That's why it is famous all over Nepal. So I guess it's time for our trek, and my friends are waiting for me up there in my classroom. So let's go and visit them. So we are almost near to Panchakanya conservation area. You can see the forest right there. So yeah, it's a really hot day and I'm full of sweat. My friends have already left me, so let's be quick.
Hello, it's me, Kusal Gurung. So now we are in Bijaipur conservation area. You can see it written on this board as well. This place is full of greenery and peace as it is away from the city area and its pollution and noises. I feel really relaxed and peaceful here. You can come here with your family for a walk as well as to worship in the temple. So now let's head on to the temple.
Guys, it's me Savera. I am standing in front of the main gate of Panchakanya. This temple is one of the famous temples of Dharan. In Nepal, Panchakanya means five girls. In this temple, mainly five goddesses are worshipped. So let me call out their names. The first one is Ahalya, second one is Draupadi, third one is Tara, fourth one is Kunti, and the last one is Mandodari. Unfortunately, today this temple is closed, but you can come other day and worship the goddess. Thank you.
Namaste.
तपाईं यो मन्दिरको बारेमा के के थाहा छ हामीले थोरै भनिदिनु है
हुन्छ
यो मन्दिर कहिले र कसरी सुरुवात भयो
यो मन्दिर कसरी सुरुवात भयो भने सत्ययुगमा देवी उत्पत्ति भएको ठाउँ यही हो पाथिभरा त्यस पछाडी मान्छे सबै सृष्टि गरेर आकाश पाताल सबै सृष्टि गरेर त्यस पछाडी मान्छे सृष्टि गर्नुभयो भगवानले मान्छे सृष्टि गरेपछि भगवानले मान्छेलाई खाने अन्न पात सबै उत्पत्ति गर्नुभयो तर मनुष्यले भगवानलाई केही पनि दिएन नदिएको हुँदाखेरि ल मलाई मान्छेको भोग दिनु भनेर भगवानले भन्दाखेरि मान्छेले भोग नदिने पर्यो मान्छेको भोग दिन त देवताले खाँदैन कसरी दिनु भनेर केही पनि दिएन नदिँदाखेरि देवतालाई पनि भोक लाग्यो तिर्खा लाग्यो यहाँबाट निक्लिएर गएर ताप्लेजुङ एक रात बास बसेर गुरुङको पाँच सय भेडा लुकाएर अनि एउटा सानो जामालाको बालखा निक्लियो अरे निक्लिएर एउटा भेडा दिए मलाई दिउँछु भन्दाखेरि कोठालाले म भेडा दिन्न भन्यो त्यस पछाडि अनि किन कराएको यो केटी कहाँबाट आएको भनेर कोठालाले भन्दाखेरि केटी हरायो केटी हराइसकेपछि भेडा पनि हराए अनि ताप्लेजुङमा गएर त भेडा कोठालाले भेडा खोज्दै बस्यो रात त्यहीँ पऱ्यो जङ्गलमा रात परिसकेपछि पछाडि भेडा गोठालो जङ्गलमै सुत्यो जहाँ भेडा कोठा हराएको थियो त्यहीँ सुत्दाखेरि फेरि रुखको फेदबाट केटी निक्लिएर ए मनुष्य तँ किन यहाँ सुतेको जङ्गलमा तँलाई डर लाग्दैन भनेर केटीले भन्दाखेरि होइन मेरो भेडा हरायो भनौँ गुरुङले हो मलाई दिउँसो पाँच एउटा भेडा दिए भन्दा दिनस् मलाई हकार पकार पारिस् तर अब तेरो भेडा मलाई पाँचवटा दिनुपर्छ काटेर भोग अनि म तेरा भेडा देखाइदिन्छु भनेर फेरि केटीले भन्दाखेरि ल हुन्छ तपाईँ त भगवान् पो रहेछ म त थाहै भएन मैले चिन्नु सकिनँ भनेर गुरुङले भन्यो अनि भोलिपल्ट बिहान उज्यालो भएपछि भेडा भेटायो गुरुङले अनि गुरुङले घरमा गएर धुपछि त फुलपाती सबै थोक ल्यायो ल्याएर पाँचवटा भेडाको भोग दियो पञ्चकन्ने पाथिभारा भनेर नाम राखेर भोग दियो पहिलो भोग पाथिभाराले गुरुङको हातबाट खायो खाइसकेपछि त्यस पछाडि भोग दिनुपर्ने रहेछ भनेर सबैले भोग दिन थाले पाथिभारालाई तपले जाउँदेखि फेरि देउता निक्लिएर आएर मान्छेको जिउमा उत्पत्ति हुनुभयो मान्छेको जिउमा उत्पत्ति भएपछि मेरो ठाउँ ठेगान पञ्चकन्या हो मेरो सृष्टि यो खालको हो भनेर हामीलाई देखाउनु भयो कि अनि त्यही अनुसारले हामीले अहिले बताइदिँदैछौँ
हजुर अनि जस्तै तपाईँले भन्नुभयो त्यो गुरुङको हातबाट भोग खानुभयो अहिलेसम्म यो मन्दिरमा अहिलेसम्म कस्तो कतिले त्यस्तो भोग बुझाएका छन्
विश्वास गर्नेले ल्याउँछ नानी विश्वास नगर्नेले ल्याउँदैन
यो मन्दिर चाहिँ कसले बनाएको
यो मन्दिर बनाउने चाहिँ निरा तामाङ हो
निरा तामाङ उहाँ धरानकै हो
उहाँ धरान नौ नम्बरमा बस्नुभएको थियो
अनि तपाईँ जस्तै अघि मलाई भन्नुभयो तपाईँहरूमाथि देउता चढ्नुभयो देउताले केही आज्ञा दिनुभयो र गर्नुभयो देउता गरेपछि तपाईँलाई कस्तो महसुस हुँदै थियो त
मलाई देउता चढिसकेपछि महसुस कस्तो पनि भएन नानी त्यतिकै कस्तो ढङ्गमै लागे जस्तो हुन्थ्यो अनि यो भन् त्यो भन् उस्तो भन् उस्तो भन् भनेर सबै उहाँले सिकाउनु हुन्थ्यो अनि म कता
Hello friends, we are again in our second destination which is you can see a beautiful small temple beside me and it's the Vrindavasini temple so let's go and get some closer looks Okay, right now I'm standing in front of Vrindavasini temple but unfortunately it is closed so you can get some closer looks from outside only there is a small statue of Vrindavasini Devi and some trishuls and some worship those stones are worshipped holy stones so right now I'm standing at the place where our Kirati ancestor had ruled for several years This area is known as Bijaipur area where the Kirat Kalin Mahal, the Bijaipur Palace was once situated and this place is known as the place of Patabhunga Mahal right now. So this place holds tons of historical and archaeological importance. It holds its name in the history of Nepal like before the unification of modern Nepal by the late King Prithvi Narayan Shah. But as you can see like the whole palace area is now nothing is left like whole destroyed. But yeah and only few people know about it like about it. So me as well I knew about this place in an article and as I researched about it I came to know that the famous archaeologist Iman Singh Chembong he had written in his book the Kirat Kalin Bijaipur where he had stated that this place was previously known as Bijaipur Gadi which was ruled by the Kirat king Bijay Narayan Rai in 1854 so this place was supposed to be the capital of the kingdom so let's go and take some closer looks
due to the lack of care of our government, lack of the care of local people, lack of the knowledge of the heritage heritage. So we must protect them, preserve them, because this place does not only hold the glorious history, but also this are our identity, our pride. It just give us an identity. These are the gift of our ancestor. We must preserve them, protect them, so our future generation also can get proper knowledge about this. So thank you.
So we have finally reached at our school again, and it was a really tiring day. We are like, everyone is so tired, you can see. So that was a really lovely day. We got to visit so many new places, we interacted with new people and got to learn so many things. I hope you guys enjoyed with us as well. So this much for today. Meet in the next video. Bye bye.